What is a disability? In the dictionary, it is defined as a physical or mental limitation that limits one's movements, senses, or activities. Limit, that's a harsh word. With technology, physical disabilities are only a state of mind.
One of the things I've been talking in deeply is about wheelchair, because if you train somebody to be independent and you don't give him or her appropriate wheelchair, it's like you have done nothing. If you don't have appropriate wheelchair, that is the time when really you feel that you are disabled. But if you have appropriate wheelchair which meets your needs, suits you, you forget about that disability.
In creating the most innovative technology for distinct situations, we look to our local Center for Assistive Rehabilitation and Robotics Technologies, or CAART. In order to gain a more comprehensive understanding, we look to the director of CAART, Dr. Rajiv, Dubey.
What is your role in the CAART project? What are your specific duties?
I'm the director of CAART. So we've done one project. I mean, the CAART is in like an umbrella, right. You know, it's a center. And as I described to you, different projects, like the wheelchair-mounted robotic arm, prosthetics, dance chair, driving simulator, undergraduate project. So I have to kind of oversee kind of the whole overall what is going on.
Why and how did you choose to come to research at USF?
One of the reasons I came to, it's a twofold. I mean, I came here as a department chair, so I'm also a department chair of mechanical engineering. So I was interested in some administrative position also at that time when I moved here. Plus, I wanted to do, I've been doing research in robotics from the beginning, from my PhD. And when I was in Tennessee, my research was focused on space. Like, I worked with NASA on space robotics, you know, robots that go on a shuttle and so on. Then I also work with Department of Energy on nuclear waste cleanup. So, you know, you need robots to handle nuclear waste, you know. So anything hazardous environment, you know, you have robotic devices to do that. So most of my research was related to those things, kind of in space and you know. But then I wanted to shift my focus and wanted to use robotics technology for people. So I want to connect robotics with people and how this could be used to help people, especially people with disabilities. And so here is a place where there was some opportunity for me to work. But I wanted to, you know, apply the robotics technology for social causes or whatever, for people with disabilities, for the elderly, in whatever way it could help people. And so I felt like here there was an opportunity because we got one of the largest VA hospitals across the street, and Florida has a big elderly population, you know, from the demographics, with the medical school here, nursing school, hospital, Shriners Hospital. So this was perfect location, I felt, where I could, you know, work with the folks in health sciences, so we have a good school of physical therapy, to work with them and combine the robotics engineering side with the health side and work on interesting robotics projects like that. So that area is called Rehabilitation Robotics, and then as you heard, our center is called Center for Assistive Rehabilitation Robotics Technologies. So that was my motivation to come down here. The state of Florida, you know, has a program out of Tallahassee called the Division of Vocational Rehabilitation. Okay, what they do is they have rehab engineers throughout the state of Florida, and technicians and engineers, about 12, 13 of them. So they were managed through the state office in Tallahassee, this vocational rehabilitation engineering program. And at that, the governor at that time, Jeb Bush, he wanted to privatize some of that. And so they had a, what they call the RFP, request for proposals. So we wrote a proposal and we got the contract from the state. So now the rehab engineering program from vocational rehabilitation is run through USF. And it is part of CAART. So we have this contract that's like we've completed in 11 years now. So we have these engineers like in Miami, Tallahassee, Orlando, Jacksonville, Fort Lauderdale, and so on, and technicians, rehab engineers and technicians. So what happens is somebody who has a disability, okay, and they want to work. So what they do is they contact their counselors, local counselors, and the counselor connects with our engineers and technicians. And then our engineers are like consultants on rehabilitation or assistive technology. So our engineer will make a recommendation that this is the right kind of wheelchair for you, this is how you modify your van so you can get in and out, this is how you modify your workplace or home. So they're involved in all those things. They make recommendations so that people can go to work. You know, people who are disabled can work. But a lot of times the solutions are not there. You know? I mean, you need something more complicated device for a person with a disability to do something related to their job. So what we do is there are two things that are done. One is at the undergraduate level, because this is housed in mechanical engineering, we have senior design projects that are called capstone design. So we have engineers bring the problems from the field, things for which solutions do not exist, and they present those problems to the class, design class, and then the design class, they make groups of 3-4 people and make a team, and then they work with the individual who needs some assistive device, and during that semester they design something, they actually build something, and test it and see if the person can, it's like a make a prototype. The cool thing about that is, I mean, they're so motivated because they're working on a gadget. It's not just making something, but on a device that is going to be used by somebody, could be useful, and it might change somebody's life. You know? And then if it is successful, they could make more of those and could be used by other people with similar disabilities, ideas. And so some of these ideas that come out of these undergraduate projects are converted into commercial products. You know, students apply for a patent, and then, you know, if it becomes a commercial product, then they get some revenue out of the, you know, the sales and so on. But some of the stuff that you'll see, we have a wheelchair mounted robotic arm that we're working on. So these things are down the road, could be useful for people who are wheelchair bound, and plus they're limited in their ability to function with their upper extremities also. So you attach a robotic arm and then with a joystick to try to, you know, pick up objects, move things out of the way, open a door, and so on.
Dr. Dubey provided us with some footage of his wheelchair-mounted robotic arm in action.
were there any projects that didn't work out in the end that were that you guys worked on?
Yeah, I mean, it always happens in any project. We try, that's what research is. You don't know what is going to happen. You don't know the answer. That's what that, I mean, that's by definition, that is the research. You know, so you're looking for the right solution. So every step of the way, you're going to find something that doesn't work out, and then you try something else. So whether it is theoretical work or whether you're building something, it doesn't work. So.
Although he is in charge of the entire center, Dr. Dubey still finds time to work on projects of his own. The current project of interest is the wheelchair-mounted robotic arm.
The whole idea is when somebody is in a wheelchair right now, you look at the camera view of the room and say, for example, you come to this object, and the screen is going to show this thing. Then I tap on that object on the screen, and essentially, what I'll do is to try to focus on that and then try to forget its location. And it tries to match. We have the database of objects, standard objects that normally you want to pick up or you want to use in day-to-day living. And so it knows the size of it. It knows from the sensors. It can find out how far it is. And it can command the wheelchair to go there and grasp it. So this is for an individual who has not only in a wheelchair, but cannot use the arm.
So this object is there in the database, and once you selected it, sort of centers the arm position on the color based on the color of your object. So it blocks the target. And so now the shift is over, so it has matched the object. It has centered as much as it should have, and now it's going to grasp it. You don't have any force control, so it'll probably stop at some predetermined configuration.
Yeah. So now it's just like you command the arm to move that way.
So the
user can now switch to a joystick control and then kind of pick it up. So the idea is whatever it can do on its own, it does, and then the user can also take control of it. So all this electronics was designed and built here, you know, and this is used to control the robot arm. Yeah. This may be one of the most sophisticated wheelchairs you've seen.
Technological innovations such as these have allowed people to live their lives to the fullest.